In this video, I'm going to explain anatomical relationship of axilla. This area is axilla. Axilla means armpit. There are many muscles and other tissues crossing around axilla. That's why this area is very, very important. Let me explain what kind of muscles are around axilla. This is pectoralis major, pec major. This is big muscle in front of chest. These are biceps, biceps brachii. And there are very big muscle on back part of shoulder, which you don't see in this video. There is latissimus dorsi. This is subscapularis. This is part of rotator cuff muscle. And there are many, many other muscles. It's like this and this and this. Many muscles cross scapula and shoulder joints. So somehow, each muscle has relationship with axilla, okay? So what happens if one of these muscles get tight? That can inhibit movement of scapula, movement of shoulder, and that can create tightness around this area, okay? And why is, you know, axilla related? Let's say pectoralis major is here that composes the part of axilla that can inhibit movement of shoulder. See this relationship? So tight muscles can inhibit movement of shoulder, and maybe tight fascia around axilla can inhibit movement of shoulder. Does it make sense? Now let me move on to other tissues. So this is axilla area with nervous tissue and blood vessels. These yellow things are brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is bundle of nerves. You know, many nervous fibers here. And there is artery running through axilla. This is subclavian artery and axillary artery. Name is different, depends on the section, okay? But this is just continuation of artery, okay? Axillary artery or subclavian artery. Then there is vein also. This is, you know, subclavian vein. These are veins. So there are nervous tissue and blood vessels. As I said, there are many muscles, nervous tissue, and blood vessels running through axilla. So what happens when one of these tissues get damaged? Maybe brachial plexus gets damaged. That can affect artery. That can affect muscles. That can affect, you know, vein, maybe, you know. Then, what happens if humerus gets fractured? That can aggravate nervous tissue. That can aggravate blood vessels, muscles. Because this area is very, very busy place, one tiny injury, one tiny tension can create big problem this area. Again, what kind of tissues are there? Muscles, nervous tissues, and blood vessels. If I want to add one more thing, there is lymphatic nodes around axilla. You know, axilla is big terminal of lymphatic flow for upper body. That's why axilla is also important place for lymphatic system. Oh my gosh, this is very busy and important place. In this video, I explained basic anatomy and anatomical relationship of axilla. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.